Likewise, if we are interested in finding the total number of input box or edit box in a method in a particular web page, how we can tweak the same thing to find it out. So I'm going to create a new test method, and I'm going to call it. I have to specify to make it a script. I have to write test method attribute, and then I'm going to write method total input box. Okay. So these first I have to launch the browser. Let's say this time I'm going to pick some other web page, okay? Let's say facebook.com. I will be writing facebook.com, and then I have to create object. So just see how I'm going to tweak how I'm going to make control. So I'm going to say input box. Technology will still holds the same web. Let me change the names here. And now the control type is not going to be hyperlink. Okay. Let's look at the Facebook. I'm going to spy. Let's say these are the input box that we need to find. So let's try to find some of the property. So in as far as the input box goes, the control type is going to be edit. When we were interested for hyperlinks, control type was hyperlink, but for input box it's edit. So I have to make the control accordingly. I will be writing here edit, and that's done. Right now, same thing I can do. I can say integer count is equals input box dot find matching controls dot count will give the total number of controls. And we, in order to print it, I would say console dot write line, sorry, write line, and I can say count. That's it, done. Okay, let's try to run this particular test. Okay, so at this point, this particular test is going to count the total number of input box in the facebook.com page. I'm going to launch this. I'm going to run this test directly and calculating. So total input box output, say 8 controls. Okay, fantastic. Let's say now, okay, here is one assignment that you guys have to do. Write a script to find total controls in a web page. Okay, it may be edit box, it may be hyperlink, it may be button, or any control. I need to count the total number of controls in a web page. So the trick there is going to be, we cannot use this particular statement, right? Edit or hyperlink or something. So what else we can see? So what you do is you try this out. It's pretty simple, straightforward, not a rocket science. think smartly. Use one of the property like, I'm just trying to hint, give you a hint. I don't want to give the exact thing, otherwise you will not be able to think on it. Let's say control is there. This will create a control. Okay, it will come. It will store all type of controls. We got it right. We just have to see whether the control exists is true or control enabled is true. Maybe either of those two properties, control is enabled or control is visible or control exists. That's it, right? So, and then you can print, you will get it. Okay. Now the next thing is we need to, let's say in this particular case, right? We were working on, we did find total number of links. I am interested now to print total links, whatever it comes. I think it, in this particular case, it was coming 28. I need to know what are those total links. Okay, so I'm going to write a method to print all the links in a web page. Okay, so why don't I go and copy the same thing? I will save some time. I'm going to introduce a new concept here, UI test control collection, and that's how we are going to iterate each and every object of the same type. Okay, so I will say print total links in a web page. Okay, now I am not interested in counting, or maybe let's say let it be there. I'm going to remove the validation at this point. We will be working with validation in very detail, so don't bother at this point in time. Just trying to understand the core concepts, how we play with the objects, because that's very, very important. Okay, so I created a control of type hyperlink. Now I have to print it. Okay, so how to do it? What I'm going to do is I'm going to write loop for each. Control, okay. For each, oh, it's not coming. Hold on. For each UI test, control. Okay, it was not coming somehow. For each UI test control, I have to iterate through all links in this links, right? So all links in links dot find matching controls. Okay, it will iterate me through all the controls. Now I have to print the name, correct? So let's try to browse one of the object and see how we can find that name. Maybe we can either print the name property, or sometimes name is not there, we can print inner text also, because sometimes developers put the inner text. Oh, sorry, I ran this test. Hold on, I just cancel it, it's gonna fail, so don't bother. I will be launching the coded UI test builder, and let's try to analyze one object. Let's say one test solution. Okay. So here I have to print this. Either I can print inner text, or name is there. Let's see. Friendly name is there, that we can print this also. Name is blank. There is no name. So let's say if I print basically inner text for all the controls, that means we will be able to populate, we will be able to print all the links of a web page. So how to do it? So I'm going to write console dot write line in order to print. What I have to print? I have to print. I will be doing this. Link name is this plus total lengths all lengths dot get property. Get property is basically method that returns the property type. So inner text is also basically a property, right? And then I can write property name. Property name is inner text. Inner text. And it will print me for all the links, it will give me inner text, and that's what we are going to print. Okay, let's run this quickly. It's launched. It would be scanning through all the objects. And okay, so the test is pass. I'm selected this. Okay, cool. See, it printed all the links. For some of the links, you are not able to see the name here. Nothing is printed. Why? Because the inner text may be blank for those controls, for those hyperlinks. So this is how we can scan through all the links. Okay. So again, you try one more example on this when you are going to try populating all the controls in a web page. Try to print all the names of controls also. Okay, so now I feel we will be getting some confidence in terms of creating the object or in terms of calculating or populating a different controls in a web page. That's very, very important. Most of the time in an interview, people ask how to count the total number of links in a web page, how to display all these things. So these things are very small, but very important, very conceptual. Now, next thing is, let's look at what we did cover. We covered these things, controls. Okay, let's try to understand what is parent and child controls. We have seen how to assign properties, what are search and filter properties, that also we have seen. We have seen counting these, populating, validations we saw a little bit. We have a separate session for it, UI validations and assertions, where we will be connecting to the database, validating the UI from the database in order to ensure the integrity of the data. Then we wrote a test also. We look at some of the example for edit boxes where we were trying to find out some value. Let's try to understand what are parent and child controls before we wind up this particular session for today. Okay, so I'm going to spy, let's say I'm this particular module. Okay, let's spy this test. I want to spy this object. Let's say enroll now. Okay, this is also a hyperlink. You click here. It's called a show UI control map. So coded UI creates a map. Map is basically nothing but the hierarchy of the controls. You see here UI enroll now hyperlink is the control. It populated all the search properties, some control specific properties, and some generic properties. Now every control these individual end UI controls will have a parent. If there is no parent, for sure there will be a browser window object as a parent. But here, if you look at the hierarchy here, from this UI map, the immediate parent seems to be for UI enroll now hyperlink is this. It may not be true. Okay, it may not be true. How to find the parent? So I'm going to refresh it just to make sure it populates again. You see here this small arrow, right? It says move to the parent control in the application. So I'm going to click here. It will see this was a parent. It was a hidden object, so it was not populating. Again, I have to find what is the parent of this particular thing. I selected this and I'm going to click on this. This is the parent, like this. So from up arrow, upwards arrow, we go to the parent. From bottom arrow, we go to the child. and from side arrows we go to the siblings. Okay, let's say I'm going to click right now, it's highlighted this particular image. If I click and find out what is the sibling of it, this is the next sibling of it. Okay, let's say if I'm going to spy this particular control and I need to, I just gone to the parent of it, I want to find the sibling of it. So I will click this. This is the next sibling of it. This is the next sibling. This is the next sibling. So that's how we navigate from child to parent controls and from one sibling to another sibling. As far as the window web-based application goes, most of the time we have to just, for every control that we create, if we are passing the browser window as a parent, it works. But that may not be true when it goes to grids or when it goes to table. So we will see how we will work with those. And for Windows-based application or WPF-based applications, we need to write explicitly create parent objects or child objects or maybe siblings, something like that. That's the same applies when we work with an application which is integrated with a third-party application. Let's say I'm working on a WPF-based application, but it's integrated with the Telrix. So if from my experience, we may have to pass the immediate parent for a particular object in order for it to work. That we will see over the period of time. We'll be working with the complex examples. But right now, I don't want to make the things complex because we just started. That's our first session. We have to understand. We get each and every concept of it. Okay. So that's pretty much. We'll move to the, we'll look after the next session. Let me give a quick brief what we are going to talk about in next session. So we are done with this particular topic. Here we will be working with technology specific controls where we will not be creating an object of UI test control. However, we will be creating an object for the HTML control type that is technology specific. We would be optimizing a lot of code in terms of creating objects. And also we will be using strongly typed in order to assign the properties. Okay. All right. Fantastic. Practice it out. In case of any questions, please email back. All right, thank you.